Teşekkür ederim Sayın Başkan. Hayırlı sabahlar hanımlar ve cenaplar. Thank you very much first inviting to this distinguished meeting. Before starting my presentation,
I'm sorry. I ask all presentation please take into our time, maximum 15 minutes.
Okay. I was involved in the preparation of master plan for the Upsheron Peninsula, the greater Baku region, and that study started in the year 2011 and ended 2013. So it took 24 months to complete. In the opening session, I listened to Professor Ramiz Mehmetov. He mentioned about how scattered is the water sector and how many ministries and institutions are involved in water sector. And I would recommend you to read, to go over the master plan, which is thousands of pages, 18 tasks, and each task report is several volumes. And one of the volumes, one of the tasks, water legislation in Azerbaijan, and comparison of this legislation with other countries and with international laws and so on. And another volume, since there was a question, therefore I felt that it would be nice to inform you. One of the tasks was also reuse of the treated wastewater, and a very thick volume, and discussing water reuse practice in several countries and standards applied national at international level. In the study, master plan study, we also investigated financial analysis, what water tariff to be applied in order to cover the expenses for the next 20, 25 years up to the year of 2035. And at the early phases of this master plan period, annually 1 billion euro of investment is needed. The total investment is in the order of 12 billion euro. And we also studied how the capacity is going to be built and what actions to be taken to strengthen the Azersu as a water institution. So I would really recommend you to go over those reports, and you will find very comprehensive discussion, solution, recommendation, and output of a study which took 2 years. After this introduction, I will start my presentation. And my presentation involves, first, what do we understand from water shortage? Because in this conference, we are saying there are two keywords, global and the water shortage. So what is water shortage? What is water scarcity? And what is the global water balance? And really, is there water shortage at global level? Or is this a problem at local level or regional level? And what measures are taken and can be taken? And finally, transboundary water issues will be taken up. Let me first start with the definition of water shortage. There are several definitions of it, and there is classification of the countries regarding supply side or annual water resources. According to one definition, there might be some others. If annual availability of water is more than 1,700 cubic meter per capita. This is acceptable, and water shortage is local and rare. But if the annual water resources per capita less than 1,000 cubic meter, then you can expect adverse effects on health, economic development, and human well-being. But there are some cases or some countries or some regions where you may have even less than 500 cubic meter per capita per year, then this will really limit the development and becomes constraint for life. There are other definitions, and one of them is UN indicator to indicate the shortage, scarcity of water. And according to this indication, if water withdrawal in a country greater than 40% of annual water resources, country is considered to be water scarce. The assessment should not be based on the supply side, should be considering also demand. So any definition depending only on the available water or water supply might be misleading. Now let us come to global water balance. If we consider the whole Earth, total annual precipitation on Earth, 108,000 cubic kilometer. But out of this amount, 60%, that means 61,000 cubic kilometer evaporates back. So what is left is 47,000 cubic kilometer, which is available water, and that is flowing towards sea. But we cannot use all of this water. So out of this 47,000 cubic kilometer of water, we can use a part of it, but even if we assume that this is evenly distributed to the population of the Earth, this would make 9,000 cubic meter per capita per year. So that means there is no problem at the global level. But as I have mentioned, not all of this water can be controlled and usable. Only 9,000 cubic kilometer to 14,000 cubic kilometer may ultimately be controlled and utilized. So if we look at this, only 3% of total precipitation and 24% to 38% of the utilizable water is withdrawn for use. When we look at Turkey, where I am coming from, the water balance in Turkey or on Turkey. In Turkey, total annual precipitation is 501 cubic kilometer. Annual usable or utilizable water is 112 cubic kilometer. And currently, Turkey is using 44 cubic kilometer of water, which is 39% of the usable water potential. Now, when we look at demand versus annual precipitation, total annual precipitation is much more than enough to meet the demand. So when we look at the global level, there is no problem. Then the question, why water shortage? Why are we talking about water scarcity? The reason, quite simple. Yes, there is enough precipitation, there is enough water, but unfortunately, precipitation occurs during wrong time on the wrong place. Or there is precipitation on the place which we do not need water, or during time there is no need for water. There you see map of Turkey. Pardon, actually. Yeah, I should bring this slide. For example, when we look at Turkey, northeast part of Turkey, precipitation is 2.5 meters annual precipitation. If you look at the inner part of the Turkey, 1/10, 250 millimeters per year. But the more water is demanded in the inner part, in the middle part where agriculture is quite intensive. And if you look at the northwestern part where Istanbul is located, demand is great, but there is no enough precipitation. So how are we going to address this problem? So this brings us to the measures. Supply side measures, problem of seasonal distribution. This is obvious, and this is not new. For centuries, for 1,000 years ago, we had the same problem, and the solution actually simple, but also expensive. Problem of seasonal distribution, to address this, to solve this problem, we are constructing dams or storage facilities. This is obvious and being done. But there are some countries or developing countries, they have resources, but they are not in a position to build enough storage facilities to address this uneven seasonal distribution of precipitation. It is, when you look at this conceptually, is simple, but when it comes to application to the practice, is expensive, and not every country in a position to do that. And when you look at to the problem of spatial distribution, so that means spatial on land, and geographically not even. What we are doing, what has been done hundreds of years ago, we are doing the same. Construction of transmission line. There you see a picture to transport water from Turkey to the island Cyprus, and that project is under construction. Since there is not enough water, water from Turkey mainland to the Cyprus is going to be transported. If we take Istanbul, now Istanbul is receiving water from Melen River, which is about 200 kilometers away from Istanbul. And the demand is in one location, but supply is on other location. So the solution is engineering solution. So bring the water by pipelines to the place where you need water. Again, solution simple, but not cheap always, and there is no enough resources always. I have mentioned about the master plan for city of Baku, and Baku was suffering from water shortage. And still, that problem has not been solved. If you look at the availability of the water resources, yes, there is enough water resources, but the problem is distribution of water and also very high unaccounted for water or leakage and losses of water. And luckily, master plan could bring a solution to this problem, even by relocating the reservoirs. Annual saving, pumping saving, energy saving is 10 million manat per year. Just simple relocation of the reservoirs. Again, in Baku, the water is brought from far distances. Şollar, Samur, Kür. They are all coming from far distance. And what are we using? We are using the transmission lines. These are conventional and simple conceptually, but when it comes to engineering application, they are not that simple and they are expensive. I mentioned for Baku to bring the water, wastewater and stormwater business up to the standards of EU, let me say, you need an investment of 12 billion euro in during coming 20 years. And other options, reuse. Reuse is quite potential, and there is a high potential for Baku as well, and we studied, and I would ask you to refer to our report, master plan report. Desalination is another one to consider, but after you consider storage, transmission, if you are not in a position to solve the problem, then you can consider the following options. But sometimes it may go by parallel. That depends on the location or specificities of the location. Other measures, demand side, water conservation, very simple, reduction of the demand. But saying simple, when it comes to application, and there are three pillars of effective water conservation. First one, education, awareness rising. So people should be convinced that this is a necessary, that everybody should do water conservation. But this is not enough. You have to have technology in the market. You are, whether you are owner of industry, or you are farmer, or you are a household person, you are willing, you are wishing to save the water, but if there is no techniques, technology in your country, you cannot do it. And in 1990s, Turkey was the same, and I studied on water conservation. There was no technology, water-saving devices, water-saving piping and so on. But now these are available, so technology. The third one, this is also inevitable. Rational water tariffs, water pricing. If you do not have rational water tariff on the basis of full or partly full cost recovery, you will not be able to implement your water conservation. Since I think my timing is just 2 minutes more, okay. Just transboundary waters. How important is the transboundary waters? There you see, there are on Earth 261 transboundary waters, and transboundary water basins form about 45% of Earth's land surface. So half of Earth is transboundary water. And about 40% of the world's population live on the transboundary water basins, and 60% of the flow is transboundary in nature. There are 145 countries on the transboundary water basins, and 19 transboundary basins have 5 or more countries, riparian countries. Now, the main theme of this conference is also transboundary water. And I would say that it is essential that the water resources, supply side, and water management, water demands, are very well managed before discussing the controversial issue of the sharing of the flows. So usually the mistake done before assessing properly what are the water resources, and before attempting what countries can do to control the demand, you know, they are negotiating the how to share, how to divide the water. This is not the right approach. First, you have to manage your supply side, you have to manage your demand side, and then go to controversial issue of water flows. And the joint study is to harmonize the data, and the speakers mentioned about this before me. These joint studies, harmonizing the data or data calibration, intercalibration, exchange of data, these are good initial steps for trust buildings. And I am personally involved in some of this type of studies for Turkey. Also, I would draw your attention, so far, 1,228 events of cooperation versus 507 events of conflict. So cooperation type of events are dominating, and most of the events are on water quantity rather than water quality, though quality is also picking up. Now I will past this, because in the conclusions, let me go to conclusion part. Global water analysis demonstrate that the total water on Earth is sufficient to meet the total demand. The main reasons of water shortage is the uneven spatial and seasonal distribution of the precipitation. Water transmission lines and water storage reservoirs are built to address these problems. Reuse of water and the desalination of the seawater may also be applied to increase the supply of water. Water conservation as demand side management can be quite effective to eliminate the imbalance of supply and demand. And finally, there are, as I mentioned to you, 261 transboundary waters on Earth, which forms the 60% of the river flows. Water is a basic human need, and the transboundary waters should be used in equitable, reasonable, and optimum manner. Pardon. The principle of sharing the benefits at basin level should be pursued. Water issues should be regarded as a catalyst for cooperation rather than a source of conflict. The water shortage at global level can only be addressed through an integrated approach and with technical and financial support by the developed countries, regional and international organizations, and financial institutions. With this, I conclude my presentation. Thank you very much for your attention.